As time flies to 15th January, when the Non-Aligned Movement Summit is slated to kick off, more heads of state are confirming attendance of the summit to be hosted in Kampala. According to the Minister of Foreign Affairs, over 90 delegations have confirmed attendance. During an interview with Urban TV, Vincent Bajire, the permanent secretary of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, noted that each delegation is expected to be composed of 5 official delegates to accompany the head of the delegation. But the government will only foot the bill of the heads of delegations plus the other 3 delegates.
Uganda shall be in a position of influence. We shall be in position to attract investors, their countries whose heads of state had not stepped in Uganda and did not have any plans to come to Uganda. They are going to come here on account of these 2 summits.
Government has already secured over 5,000 beds to accommodate delegates, and 7 hotels have been identified to host the heads of delegations, including Munyonyo Commonwealth Resort, Serena Hotel Kampala, Serena Chigo, Four Points Serena, Mestil, Sheraton, and Naguru Skies Hotel. Other hotels will also be used for other delegates. President Museveni will chair the 2 summits, starting with NAM of 120 member states and G77 of 134 member states. Bajire says the 2 summits will change Uganda's landscape on the international scene to attract more investors.
We have in excess of 90 delegations that have confirmed, and this includes member states. It includes special guests that HE, the president, has invited, and also includes observer organizations and observer states. So the format of the summits shall be 1+5. So at the minimum, we expect each delegation to have 1 person leading the delegation and another 5 that will be supporting them.
A trade and investment forum has also been organized to take place at the sidelines of the main conference, where Uganda Investment Authority shall have a chance to woo investors from member states. The government has assured the public that every Ugandan will have a keel from this event, either directly or indirectly.
We have a significant number of heads of state that are coming, and indeed it is one of the aspects that has excited us as organizers. Unfortunately, I cannot go into the details of who, which heads of state, but I want to confirm that we have a significant number, and you'll see them in Kampala in the coming few days.
The Ministry of Foreign Affairs is working with a budget of 32 billion shillings in its preparation activities. Visa restrictions have been waived for visiting delegations, and COVID-19 restrictions put to rest.
Delegates that will end up in Munyonyo will be subjected to security checks. There is no compromise as far as that is concerned. But you also need to appreciate where we are coming from. When HE, the president, agreed that we do not subject the delegates to COVID tests. We just had the UN General Assembly last September. No COVID tests were required. In December, we had the COP28 in Dubai. No COVID tests were required. So the world is slowly moving away from the tests, and these delegates have been to the General Assembly, have indeed been to COP28. So we didn't want a situation whereby we are introducing something the world appears to be moving away from.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.